This is our clip insertion assembly machine. We designed this for an automotive customer. They have wide parts and they also have some small parts. This is the large standard platform we developed for them. You notice that it has a segmented tooling plate and a fixture assembly that comes in and out with shop pins so they can change over between parts on production runs. In this application, we're installing clips on an automotive tailgate fascia assembly. This is a finished part on the lower side, so you see that we've got our fixture made out of non-mar material. We've got part clamps that actuate when the cycle starts hit to hold retain in position. Make sure we've got good backing all along the plane that we'll be installing the clips. The Visumatic design part fixture is on a slide so that when the operator loads the part, it's in a very good ergonomic position. And the machine goes through the motions for the operator and carries the part and fixture back in to present it to the robot for clip installation. We've incorporated a 4-axis SCARA robot. This one's got 800 millimeter reach, so it can accommodate all sides. And we also size it that way so that they can change over this robot assembly cell to accommodate future parts. We've got Visumatic standard VIM-700 clip insertion module mounted directly to the robot quill for our vertical down application. This machine's using a HMI that's got a graphical display that has a 3D version of the part displayed along with each clip insertion point. And these will change state as the machine's in operation, indicating that it's green, good, yellow, there was an error, or red, bad. And the PLC will keep track of all that and give you a report when the cycle's complete. We included a work light in this machine for the operator to be able to see and not be dependent on ambient plant lighting. It also serves a dual purpose because we've got two vision cameras up here in the top, and they're doing part inspection. And they're looking to verify that each and every clip was installed in its correct location to improve quality control for the plant. In this machine, we've incorporated light curtains as well as mechanical safety guarding throughout for operator protection. We're also using an opto cycle start switch. We've got an 80-20 superstructure on the top of the machine to hold our mechanical safety guarding. Down below, we've got painted tubular steel frame. It's powder coated with built-in fork tubes to make it safe for the plant to move it around and also help prevent damage to the machine. This clip insertion machine incorporates our standard Model 94 feeder platform. So you got the clip escapement, tooled stainless steel bowl, and a bulk supply hopper. So they just have to dump an entire container in here, and the hopper keeps the bowl filled at the optimal level for the operator. The entire assembly is on a slide feeder tray that locks into position during production, but it's easily opened up and pulled out when you want to do maintenance or go ahead and add some more clips. By sticking with a standard small and large platform, all of the components that you see used in the machine can be changed over to drive a screw or a nut or a bolt without making radical changes to the whole machine. All that's required is to change out the tooling that's holding the fastener and also the feeder system located in the back.